Dr. Suvachala, Scientific Director with Ziva Fertility Centers. Today we are going to discuss different treatment options which are available in infertility. There are medical management to this problem of infertility. There is a surgical method to deal with this infertility. There is treatment options which are available to deal with infertility. So each one depends on how we are evaluating the problem. If there is a problem in the anatomy and it has to be corrected by surgery, then the surgical option works very well. If there is endometriosis, if there is deformity in the tubes or the uterus or the ovaries, anything is there, then surgical option is the best option. Medical management is where we give hormonal supplements, where we give treatment for any hormonal imbalances which are there, which is causing infertility. What's important is what are the treatment options that we give a patient when they come to us for treatment from infertility. I'm going to divide them into four buckets. The first one is follicular study. This is a very simple study where if the couple is married for less than a year, they've been trying and all the parameters are fine, which is to say that she's having irregular periods, her eggs are ovulating, her husband's sperms are good, and they want to try naturally without any medication. What we do is we track the growth of their follicle. That is, we see if the egg is growing properly, and this is done by ultrasonography. When the egg is of the right size and it is ready to ovulate, it is ready to release from the ovary and wait in the tube, we tell the couple to have intercourse, unprotected intercourse, so that their chances of pregnancy are higher. This works very well for patients who have irregular periods or are not able to track the release of egg from the ovaries. This works out very well, and it can be tried about 3 to 4 times, especially if the age is less than 30 and all factors are according to what I explained. Now the second one is ovulation induction and timed intercourse. This is a very interesting procedure where the chance of success are a little higher than follicular study that I just explained. In ovulation induction, we give you medications to grow the egg. This usually starts from second day of your period cycle, second or third day. We give you tablets to grow the egg. Now this is basically so that we can control the growth of the egg, we can control the release of the egg, and so that you are able to time intercourse properly to increase your chance of success. So we give you the tablets and if necessary injections. These injections are nothing but hormones that the brain is already producing, but we are externally also giving you an extra dose so that good eggs grow from your ovaries. So when these eggs are growing, we call you for a follicular scan maybe once or twice during your first 10 days of medication. When the egg is of the right size, the egg is made to release from the ovaries and to wait in the tube. This is done by an injection called HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin, also called as the trigger injection. It triggers the egg to ovulate and wait in the tube. Now, as I said, this is called an ovulation induction and timed intercourse. So ovulation is induced by this medication, by this injection, and timed intercourse is when the couple is advised to have unprotected sex so that their success rate can be increased from simply trying on their own or through follicular study. So this is a very good method, but please remember, age has to be kept in mind, and all of the factors such as open tubes, good number of sperms, quality of sperm should be good. All these factors have to be kept in mind before deciding whether we can do ovulation induction with timed intercourse or not. Next comes IUI. IUI is nothing but intrauterine insemination. As the name suggests, these sperms are put inside the uterus. Now remember, I had explained in previous videos that semen is left behind in the vagina and the sperms swim up. That's how nature is, that the semen is not allowed inside the uterus and only the sperms have to swim up towards the egg. In intrauterine insemination, it is much like ovulation induction with timed intercourse, except that we go one step ahead than timed intercourse. What we do is give you injections and medications to make the egg grow. We also give you the trigger injection that I talked about, make the egg wait in the tube. At that time, yes, we do encourage couples to have intercourse, but we also do the most important part of IUI. We take a semen sample from the husband, purify it. Purification is nothing but removing the dead sperms, the debris, the morphologically defective sperms from good sperms, highly motile sperms, removing them from seminal plasma, removing them from all kinds of artifacts inside the semen, so that only good sperms are taken and directly transported into the uterus. This is done by a very thin catheter. There is no pain, and it is a OP procedure. It is done in the outpatient department itself. You need not get into the operation theater. This increases your chance of success from if you are at zero today, from 15% to 20%. So this is a very good procedure, but it requires that all parameters that I talked about be perfect so that we can do this. The last one is IVF, in vitro fertilization, or test tube babies, as you must have heard in olden days. But this is a very good technique where the success rate increases from 10 to 15 in IUI to 40% to 50%, depending on the age. And if the age is less and all factors are good, it also goes to 60% to 70%. So it is a very good technique where the eggs are taken out of the woman's body, mixed with her husband's sperms, embryos are prepared, and the embryos put back into the uterus. The chance of success is very high because we are selecting the best looking embryo which has the most potential to implant. Therefore, the success rate increases drastically. If you would like to understand what kind of treatment options will work for you, what are your factors, what is hindering you from getting pregnant, how best can you increase your chances, please feel free to contact us on the numbers that you see on the screen. Thank you.